I'm not looking. I'm not. Yeah, that'd be fun. That would be funny. Yes. Let me turn around. Wow. You look beautiful.
Thanks.
Oh my gosh.
You like it?
I do.
Good.
I do.
Was it what you were expecting?
I had no expectations.
Yeah.
I didn't know, but yeah, it's beautiful.
It's kind of like train is.
The train, yeah.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
Yeah, it's really nice. Good job, Dad. Oh. A1.
Now, as one thing about it that I kind of knew about this young man, it was going to take some extra for him to help guide and bring him out of his shyness. Quite often, a young man marries someone that has similar qualities of his mother. Believe me, his mother is extra.
You don't know, babe, when you hold me. Kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me, give it all. I just wanna see.
Brown eyes, yes. You're the one that I desire.
Welcome. Thank you to the friends and family that are here today to celebrate the union of Carissa and Brandon. Love isn't always perfect. It isn't a fairy tale or a storybook, and it doesn't always come easy. Love is overcoming obstacles, facing challenges, fighting it out together, holding on and never letting go. It is a short word, easy to spell, difficult to define, and impossible to live without. Love is work, but most of all, love is realizing that every hour, every minute, and every second was worth it because you both did it together.
I give you this ring.
And I give you this ring.
As a token.
As a token.
And a pledge.
And pledge.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
Will everyone please stand? It is with great pleasure to now declare that Brandon and Carissa Roberts are soon to be husband and wife. But before we do this, Brandon, you may now kiss your bride.
Hell yeah.
Face your gift. Woo! It is my privilege for the very first time to introduce and present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Roberts.
Close the door. Ooh, I love that. won't need it no more. Let's just kiss till we're naked, baby. Versace on the floor.
Fiercely confident, undeniably cool, and honestly really intimidating. Chris and I go back and forth about who's more intimidating, but I gotta tell you what, this girl, she walks around so confident, I got me shaking in my boots, and I maybe never want to talk to her, but I'm sure as hell glad I did. I go to Brownsburg volleyball games only to have to endure all the men behind me just talking about her butt the whole time. But like, let's admit, that's a donk, okay? That's a donk.
I was in eighth grade and we were coming back from a church trip and I all of a sudden had to pee on the drive home. And we get into the gas station, I run to the bathroom and Chris is like right behind me. And I tried to open the women's restroom and it was locked. And I just turned and looked at Carissa horrified. And pee was just streaming down my legs. And at the time, the guy I was about to date was like in the van. It was just not a good thing. Carissa looked at my horrified face, pushed me to the men's restroom where an old man laughed at me. And she went and asked for a mop. And she literally mopped up my pee in a gas station hallway. It's a really funny memory. And it's honestly something that reminds me of how lucky I am. How lucky I am to continue growing with her throughout our lives.
So I wish you love. I wish you happiness on your journey for the rest of your lives together. I salute you.
Can you feel it?
It's warming up.
Can you feel it, baby?